Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create building skin for facade using our wireframe to create the facade. This facade is requesting from Mr. Lewis from my previous tutorial that requesting me how to create those kind of facade. Okay, so I saw a lot of online for facade using for wireframes. I saw a lot of architecture they applying on their project for using wireframes for facade. Okay, so before I get things started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reaching out to my channel or visiting to my channel and you want to learn more about Revit, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn off for notification for learn more about Revit so you won't miss my future tutorial from my channel. Okay, so before I get things started, I would like to show you some reference photo first. It make you more interested more about this kind of facade for building skin. Let me speak to my photo first. Okay, so now as you can see, here is the facade they applying using wireframe to create this kind of building skin here. We got many options here for example here, as you can see. We got a small one as well, but actually in the tutorial, I will show you only for this one, for this facade here. And here, as you can see, and here they apply the whole building using wireframes. Okay, so now let's jump into our project together. I want to close this photo reference first. Okay, so as you can see now on my screen, there is my previous tutorial that I introduced you. So I would like to create a new project for this one. We just leave it here. Go to my file, then go to new project. This one close first. I prefer for metric architecture template, then I hit OK. I will make it fast as soon as possible because just a quick tutorial. Okay, so now I will re-edit on my Revit interface for architecture template. I go to file again. I need to create some reference plan. Go to new family for apply my generic model pattern base. Go to English. Then go to consumer, I want to apply that. Then I go into generic model pattern base, double click here. Okay, so now I read on my generic pattern base. I would like to go back, switch back to my project first because I need to know the size and width. So I want to go to my meshing and size, go to implant mask. Then just give a name for mask 1 and I can simply draw for straight line, just make it like this, then hit escape, go to my 3D here. Okay, here is my previous one, go to my new 3D default here. Okay, like this, and there I will create form, solid form. Okay, so now we got our form. I just double select all like this one and device surface and change for pattern here to those kind of make it for rainbows here. Okay, so for fit number, I will make it for 40 by 40. Hit apply. Let me see. Okay, I think it's perfect, not too small or too big. Let's turn on this one for fit distance, you will know that. Okay, I think I want to make it more. Fit number, Chinese one to fit number again. Just make it for 35 by 35. Hit apply. Okay, yes, just make it 30 by 30 because our panel here is smaller or also 30 by 30. Hit apply. Okay, I think this one is perfect for me. So I want to turn this one to fit distance. Later on, you will know the reason why I turn this one to fit distance. So I'm going back to my 3D here. Okay, so here is my pattern base model. So I just select here. Then drop down finding for rainbows here. Okay, so just like my panel there. So horizontal, we will play around and make it same as here. So I just select here again. And here is the U gradient. Just copy their cap and copy Control C. Then I will pass here Control V. Again, go to my 3D again. Select here again. Cap here, Control C. Then select here again. Select here again. And cap here again, Control V. Then I can hit apply. Sorry about that. Okay, so now I got my shape here. What I'm going to do next is quite fast. From there, just go to reference plane, just from draw on first. Make sure you turn on for 3D snapping. Use a point. I can point here, hit escape. Then I go to rectangle one, set above plane. I will set for vertical one. Okay, like this. Then I can simply draw it like this. Just make it for 10-20 millimeter. Or I can change the size, create a parameter here. I will make it for, select my dimension here. As you can see, make a temporary this dimension permanent, select here. Then you can select this one again. Go to label there, you take a look on create parameter. Create a parameter, let's say we make it for point A like this. Or you can give a name whatever you want for me. And this one, I'm going to turn this one for 1x1 for scale. So I can select here and select another guy there. Then create form, select form. So we'll be create our form, but I think this one is quite big for me. So I will make it smaller than that by go to family type, because we got assigned a new parameter already. Point A, I will make it for 10. Then I can hit apply. As you can see, this one is automatically changing. Or you want to make it bigger, you can also can. As you can see, it will be bigger, but we will make it smaller than that. Just make it 10 and apply. Then it's finished. Okay, perfect. And I just select all component here. Go to material here, and of course you can assign a new parameter for material. Make it for, just make it a wire mesh. Like this, then I can apply. Okay, so go to family tie, and there we got our material tie. You can apply by yourself. In my case, I will skip there because I know you know how to do that already. So I can hit OK first. Then I will load into my project here. Load into my project tool. Okay. Go to our 3D. Okay, so here is my project tool. I just select the whole panel there, then change this one to family 4. As you can see now, file will be generating. As you can see now, our wire mesh is running properly. So I can select here, then right click on my cursor. I want to make, okay, just leave it like this. Then I can hit finish first. Okay, so now file generating. Okay, so what I'm going to do next, I will create using model in place to create those frames around our wire mesh there. Go to my sound elevation there, because basically sound elevation is front view. So what I'm going to do next, I can go to architecture tab, component, model in place, then just run down finding for, I prefer for generic model, this one, then again it's okay. It's okay again. Then set a plan, pick a plan, pick for the front here. Then I can go to extrusion, start for rectangle, start from the bottom one, make it like this until here. Okay, hit escape. Let me see, is it perfect position? And this one I can move in a bit more, something like this. Yep. And here I can move down more like this. And what I'm going to do next, I just go to my rectangle again. Then for offset there, just make it for 50 millimeter or 100 millimeter. It depends what you want. For the depth here, I just make it for 200 for depth. So I can start from here like this one, hit escape. Then for the material type, we assign also, but you can assign by yourself. Just create here. Then create a new material, just make it for wire mesh frame. Okay, okay again. Then I can finish. Okay, so now we got our wire mesh frame already. So I just hit finish first. Go to my 3D. Okay, this one, go to our 3D. It's quite okay, as you can see, and boom, you done your wire mesh for facade. So and building skin to apply into your project is quite fast, and of course you can make it smaller or bigger. It depends on what you do on with your generic model pattern best, and of course I will make it more interesting a bit, but I don't want to change my material. I just like here, then I can override there, override by view by element, change this one for solid and make this to black color. Hit apply, then spin this for frame. There I will override again, override graphic by element, and I can make it for red color. Okay, apply again, go to my visual style view, go to graphic display option, open up for shadow or shadow cast shadow, so ambient shadow, then I can apply. Okay, and boom, you done your wire mesh for building skin is quite fast in Revit. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you for watching from start to finish, and the tutorial is present from Mr. Louis, this he requesting one. Thank you guys for joining me from start to finish, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn off for notification, because your like and your subscriber is motivate me to bring more content, bring more professional content about Revit. Okay, so thank you again. See you for another tutorial in Revit, and have a nice day. Thank you.